unexpected place, unexpectedly from Dr. Machado. You never know where you're going to learn something. And many years ago, before I had to, I was younger then, I had younger ear bumps, I didn't have to wear this sort of thing on the L, but I learned something in the L that just really transformed me and changed me into a whole new way of thinking about the world and the way that things are. First of all, you know what the L is? Have you heard of it? In Chicago? Okay, you know what the L is. Anyone ridden on the L? Okay, great. Anyone been on the morning rush on the L? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. That sense that you've got to get to that train, that train is like the most important thing in the world. Have you ever had it happen where, you know what I'm talking about, Robert, exactly. Well, where you suddenly see the train in the distance, and you know it's coming, and you know you got like this much time to get there, and you don't know you're going to make it. So if you've ever done that, I was there that one day, and I was just running like this, and I started going down, and there's a ramp where I am. You've ever been down one of those ramps, you're running down a ramp? You know what I'm talking about, Pat. So running down this ramp, it's supposed to be designed for people like with wheelchairs and stuff. That running, people are going by, and I'm just barreling by, and I'm demonstrating that anger and aggression that Pat wants to have. If you ever want to have anger and aggression, by the way, just go to the L and see the train coming, you'll feel his anger and aggression. I'm pushing people out of the way, and then I go running down the thing, and then the train's coming by. I thought, oh, I gotta catch that train. Thing in my head, gotta catch that train. There's a train. I see it going, it's getting faster and faster. The train's going by me, running, and you know how it is, you suddenly feel like you're going backwards, running. The train's going by, and the last car goes, and I just get all the way to the front, push the people out of the way, get in the door open, get in, and then almost a cardiac, and certainly lowered my heart ability to regenerate. There's another train. That's always the case. Always another train coming. I sort of started thinking of it. Wait a minute. That's true. I just waited. Another train come on. I started thinking about it. What's the rush? What do I get for coming into the train 5 minutes early? I get to work 5 minutes earlier than I would have been. Is that a good thing? Why do I want to get to work earlier? I mean, some people, you know, they've got their perfect, they've worked out everything, they've got their one thing, and my one thing is work, and that's it. Boy, I'm going for it. That's my life, my 6 month plan, my 1 year plan, my 5 year plan. Work! Yes! In that case, you got a job like that. Hey, you know, great, but I do not have a job like that. I'm a secretary. So I thought, wait a minute. So, I started thinking, what was really the rush? And I started thinking about the other things I rush at, like that light. You ever have a rush from the stoplight? And you see it counting down, and you're like, you know, half a block away, and you're thinking, no, you just make it in 5, 4, 3, 2, in the middle of the street and you're like flipping people off because I made the light, buddy. I thought, is it really that important to make the light? Is it really that important to grow? What would happen if I missed the light? I missed the train. There's always another train coming. There's always another train. So I thought about it. Well, one thing happened, my blood pressure would be a lot less. And I wouldn't be as out of breath. Who knows, I may live longer. I started thinking about that, but wait a minute. So I thought about that the whole day. Then the next day, I had to come back, and the same thing happened. There was a train back there, and I knew it was there. And I decided, I'm gonna let that go. It's too much of a work to actually get down there and get to that train, and people were just pushing by me and shoving me out of the way, and I just let them go. I just watched them all the way, and I walked down, and I got like halfway to the train. It stopped, and it took off, and I walked where the train had just left, and I waited 7 minutes, and another train came along, and I got on board, and I wasn't out of breath, and I wasn't tired, and I wasn't exhausted, and I wasn't perspiring, and nobody looked at me like, actually kind of pleasant as an L can be. And there are crazy people everywhere, and people are talking to themselves loud on the cell phones, but most importantly, it wasn't exhausting. So I started doing that, started thinking, no, I just realized there's always another train coming. I don't have to push myself or stress myself. Yes, I have to get on some train. Eventually, you gotta get on the train, yes. But you don't have to get on that train. You have to get that train right away. So have you ever had that challenge where you're pushing yourself all the time and it's great to think of a 6-year plan, a 5-year plan, a 12-year plan, whatever it is, but sometimes stop and enjoy the plan you're on right now. Just remember,